Hi everyone, welcome back to SG Dr. Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming. In this episode, we will be talking about a very common sensitive nose condition called allergic rhinitis. It is commonly known as hay fever. I see so many cases of allergic rhinitis on a daily basis. Do you have it? What are its symptoms and treatments? Watch till the end to learn more about it. And if you're new to our channel, click on the subscribe button now. What is allergic rhinitis? It is a condition where the patient suffers from nasal symptoms such as runny nose, blocked nose, nose itchiness or sneezing that is triggered by substances known as allergens. It is a very common condition and affects up to 13.1% of Singaporeans. Is there a diagnostic criteria? Well, yes, let me tell you more about it. The symptoms of allergic rhinitis are nasal running, nasal congestion, sneezing and itching, itchy throat and cough, itchy eye or teary eyes. When you have two or more of these symptoms for more than an hour a day for more than 2 weeks, it is diagnostic of allergic rhinitis. I would divide the common triggers of allergic rhinitis into home triggers, food triggers, occupational or work triggers, and seasonal triggers. Home triggers are stuff like house dust mites, infestations like cockroaches or mice, pets. Food triggers includes milk, egg white, soil and nuts, fish. And occupational triggers are items found at work like dust or cement at construction site, flour at the bakery, and seasonal triggers like pollen or mold spores during certain seasons of the year. In such cases, the sufferers have symptoms of allergic rhinitis only during that particular season, like spring, for example. Allergic rhinitis tends to run in a family and is strongly associated with other allergic conditions like asthma, allergic conjunctivitis, eczema. Allergic rhinitis can also lead to more serious infective conditions like sinus infections called sinusitis and ear infections. So how is the diagnosis made? Well, in most cases, the diagnosis is achieved through a detailed history and physical examination by a doctor. If you wish to find out exactly what type of allergens can trigger your symptoms, then further testings can be done. First, a skin prick or patch test can be done. Some of the common environmental allergens like house dust mites, cats and dog dander, cockroaches, mold, grass and tree pollens can be applied onto your skin and results may be available within 20 to 30 minutes. Intradermal provocative food test is a test which involves injecting small amounts of food extracts into the upper arm and measuring the body's reaction. This test is done more for food-triggered allergic rhinitis. After a diagnosis is made, treatment can then be started. Treatment is generally divided into a few steps. Step 1. Allergen avoidance. If you are able to identify the triggers to your allergic symptoms, avoid them. Decluttering your home, avoid having carpets. Vacuuming and mopping instead of sweeping, and using HEPA filters at home to reduce dust and other pollutants. Click on the link on the above to find out more about B-Mola HEPA filters. Allergen-proofing bed sheets and washing them with hot water weekly to reduce dust mites. Step 2. Antihistamines. Antihistamines provide relief by controlling the symptoms of allergy by neutralizing the effect of the histamine released into the bloodstream during an allergic reaction. These medications are safe for children. Examples include chlorpheniramine, Zyrtec, and Telfast. Use them periodically when required to reduce allergic rhinitis symptoms. Step 3. Intranasal steroids. These medications are very effective in reducing symptoms associated with allergic rhinitis. They work best when used continuously and with maximal effect seen after 2 weeks. Nasal steroids are very safe as they are designed to act in the nose with minimal absorption into the body, and it can be used in children as young as 3 years old. Sometimes, adjunctive treatment can also be used in the short term to reduce symptoms, such as decongestion nasal spray and antihistamine eye drops. However, these medications may cause side effects in the long run and may make symptoms worse once they are stopped. So, I would recommend a short 5 days usage at any one time. If all this do not work, then referral to an allergist may be necessary to see if other treatment like immunotherapy or other specialized medications need to be started. Do recognize that allergic rhinitis is a chronic problem that can be very irritating and disabling. However, there are treatment strategies which I have highlighted above. Allergen avoidance, regular use of nasal steroids to prevent allergic symptoms, with periodic use of antihistamines when symptoms occur, will help you control your allergic rhinitis in most cases. Subscribe, like, and share this video. Till the next time, stay safe, stay healthy.